Hello, in this video, I will explain to you how to draw the data path diagram for the instruction add $T1, $T2, $T3 when executed in the MIPS architecture. I have also given a PPT with animation. You can download it from the link provided in the description and watch the animation step by step by clicking on the click button. Using that PPT as a resource, create similar animation for the execution of any other instruction. The major functional units used in the execution of an add instruction are the instruction memory, register file, ALU, and a control unit. The data memory is not used here. In addition to these units, a control unit for generating the necessary signals, a program counter, and multiplexers are used. During the first clock period, the program counter holds the address where the add instruction has been stored. This address is given to the instruction memory and instruction is fetched from it. In the next clock cycle, 4 is added with the current value of the program counter. The current value of the program counter is coming here and 4 is added using this adder. This gives the address of the next instruction, that is PC plus 4, and it is fed to the multiplexer like this. It is connected to the 0th input of the multiplexer. The multiplexer will have two groups of lines. All the lines given to 0 will be passed to the output side if you give a 0 signal as a control signal to the multiplexer. The address for the next instruction will be passed through the multiplexer if the control signal given is 0. So this control signal is generated by the control unit using a branch signal. It is connected to a NAND gate. Since add instruction is not a branch instruction, the branch signal will be 0. When one of the inputs to the AND gate is 0, then the output of the AND gate will be 0, irrespective of the other input of the AND gate. So the output is 0. So the multiplexer will select this address. So that will come out from the multiplexer and it is given to the program counter. Now the program counter will hold the address of the next instruction. In the same second clock cycle, the instruction is decoded as per the instruction format. This is T2, so this is source register. Then T3 is also another source register, and the result will be written in the destination register T1. The address for T2 will be 5 bits. Actually, the bits from 26 to 31 will be the opcode and that will be decoded. And from this register address, the particular register will be recognized. So that address is to be given to the register file like this. It is a 5-bit address. Similarly, T3 is also used as a source register because its contents are also to be read. So the T3 address is coming from here. Bits 16 to 20 will give the address of T3. In the third clock cycle, the contents of T2 and T3 already read will be given to ALU for getting them added. But the register T3 outputted from read data 2 is not directly given to ALU. It is connected to the input marked as 0 of a multiplexer. So the contents of T3 will come out from the multiplexer only if the control line of the multiplexer is 0. So the control unit generates a control signal ALU shows like this, and this signal should be zero for register instruction. See, there are many control signals. All the control signals needed are shown here. So ALU shows is here. It should be zero for the register operation. When zero is given to the multiplexer, this data will be moved or transferred to the output, and it is connected to the ALU. So ALU will get both the operands T2 and T3, and it will be added by the ALU. But the ALU will add these two operands only if proper control signals are provided. It is an add operation, so the ALU should be instructed to add those two operands. See, for add operation, the ALU control, this one, should be 0010. So when these four bits are given to control the ALU, ALU will add these two numbers and it will give the output. And that output is connected to the zeroth input of the multiplexer. So if it has to come out from the multiplexer, a control signal should select the multiplexer with the zero signal. So another control signal, memory to register, is generated. Actually, this control signal for R-type register type instruction, that is all the operands are registers, so it should be zero. So the memory to register signal will be zero. When it is zero, the multiplexer will select these inputs and it will pass it to the output side. In the next clock cycle, this output result will be sent to write data of the register file. This data should be written into the register T1. So T1 address should be available now. So that register is selected. Actually, it is a destination register. Bits 11 to 15 of the instruction will give the address of the destination register. Here, destination register is T1. The address of the destination register is available at the input of the multiplexer. If it is to come out from the multiplexer, proper control signal should be provided. Register destination control signal is provided to the multiplexer. Actually, this should be 1, then only it will be passing through the multiplexer. So address of T1 is coming out and it is given to write address. So T1 is selected now. Write data, that is result, is available here, but this itself will not write the data in the register T1. You have to give one more control signal, that is called as register write. So after giving these two, the register write signal should be given. In that case, the result data will be written into the register T1.